Good morning, children. Welcome to your first class of computer. In your previous class, class 2, you have not studied this subject. So, in class 3, this is a new subject for you. Today, we will start with chapter 1. So, all of you take out your book, hands on, and open page number 1. The name of the chapter is Getting Started. After the completion of this chapter, you will be able to identify computer and its parts. You will learn how to open and shut down a computer, and you will also know the uses of computer. Now I'm going to start reading the chapter. All of you listen carefully. Today is Dobbo's birthday and he is feeling lonely as most of his friends are out on vacations. Dobbo's father gave him a birthday gift. Dobbo is very happy to see such a huge box wrapped in beautiful gift paper. He quickly opened the gift to find what is inside the box. Now, as today is Dobbo's birthday, his father has given him a very huge gift box. Now, can you guess what is inside that box? Okay, move to the next page. In this page, one activity is given. Join the dots below to find out what Dobbo's father gifted him. Now children, first you have to join the dots to complete the picture. After that, you will be able to guess what his father has given him. From the outline of the figure, it is clear that it is a computer. So, all of you have to write computer in this fill in the blanks given here. Dobbo's father gifted him a dash. You will write here computer. And the spelling of computer is C-O-M-P-U-T-E-R. Okay, now you will complete the picture as well as you will color the picture. Now move to the next topic. Dad is asking Dobbo, Dobbo, do you know what is a computer? A computer is an electronic machine which takes a question, processes it, and gives us a meaningful answer. Now children, electronic means the things which runs on electricity. Now the question is that fan is also as an electronic machine. How? Because it also runs on electricity. But fan is not a computer. So there should be some difference between a computer and fan. Now what is the difference? Computer is a machine which takes a question from you. It will solve the question and it will give you a meaningful answer. Yes, it will solve your problem and it will give you the answer. But fan can't do this. This is the main difference between a computer and other electronic devices. Now processes means solving the problem. Whatever the problem you will give to the computer, it will solve it and it will give you the answer. Now move to the Next activity. Dobbo wondered what else a computer can do. Help him find out some other uses of computer by listing them in the space provided using the words given in the help box. Now in the help box it is given games, movies, songs, information, draw, and some fill in the blanks are given here. We have to fill the blanks with the correct words. Now first one is, a computer can be used to play dash. Now what should be the word over here? Computer can be used to play games. Yes. Second one, we can listen to dash on computer. So what should be here? Songs. Yes, we can listen to songs on computer. Third one, we can search for dash on computer. We can search for information on computer. Have you filled it? Okay. We can watch dash on computer. So what we can watch on computer? Movies. Yes, we can watch movies on computer. And the last one is, we can also dash pictures on computer. So what we can do with the pictures? We can draw it. So we can also draw pictures on computer. Correct. Have you filled it? Okay. Dobbo was excited to get computer as a gift, though he was a bit confused. Now why he is confused? Now Dad is asking Dobbo, Dobbo, you seem confused. Are you not excited to receive computer as a gift? Now Dobbo has replied, Dad, I am excited, but I don't know much about its various parts. Dad, oh dear, your friend computer is just like you. As you have different body parts to do different work, similarly, computer also has different parts. Now, his father is going to explain him what are the different parts of computer. And we are also going to learn what are the different parts of computer. Now, children, are you excited to learn about the different parts of computer? Yes. Okay. Now move to the next page. Now, the topic is parts of computer. Now, in this topic, one by one, we are going to learn about different parts of computer. And the first one is keyboard. Now, Dad, Dobbo, which body part helps you to write, hold things, or to take food to your mouth? Dobbo, Dad, I use my dash to write, hold things, and to place food in my mouth. Now, children, can you tell me what should be filled in the dash? Yes, hands. So, Dad, I use my hands to write, hold things, and to place food in my mouth. Dad, similarly, computer has a keyboard. Now, here, we are comparing the keyboard of the computer with our hands. Why? The reason is just given here. Keyboard is used to type numbers and letters, give instructions and commands to the computer. Now, keyboard is a part of the computer which help you to enter your instructions and commands into the computer. Whatever the problem you wanted the computer to solve, you have to give it or type it through the keyboard. Now move to the next topic. monitor. Now this screen is called a monitor. Now children, just tell me, is there any device in your house which is looking similar to this monitor? Yes, everybody has seen TV. You must be having TV at your home, and TV screen is very similar to the monitor. Now in the next activity, it is given, name the device that resembles the computer monitor. So I think everybody know the answer. Yes, TV. Now a monitor has following features. It displays whatever we type. Now children, whatever you type with the help of keyboard, you will be able to see it on the monitor. It has an on and off button. Now children, just you are having on and off button in your TV. Similarly, you are having an on and off button in the monitor, with the help of which you can switch on or switch off the monitor. It is also known as visual display unit, in short VDU. Now children, the name of the monitor is also visual display unit, or you can say that monitor is also known as visual display unit because it will display whatever you will write with the help of keyboard. A monitor looks like a TV screen. We have already discussed it, that monitor is very similar to a TV. Now Dad, Dobo, call your classmates for the birthday party. Dobo, Dad, I don't remember their phone numbers and I don't have my phone book with me. Now Dad is asking Dobo to call his classmates, but Dobo don't remember their phone numbers. So what he will do now? Let's move to the next activity. Now in this activity, read the questions given below and put a tick mark at the option which you feel is correct. Now the first is, do you remember the names of all the students of your school? Children, do you remember? I think no. Yes, you can't remember all the names of students of your school. Second one, can you recall phone number of all the students of your class? That is also no. It is not possible to recall all the students' phone number. And third one is, do you remember the multiplication tables till 100? That is also no. These things are not possible. Well, we cannot remember the above mentioned things, but a computer can remember all the above. Dad, Dobo, which part of your body helps you to remember everything? Dobo, I remember everything using my brain. Yes, brain remembers everything. Dad, do you know computer also has a brain? Now Dad is telling Dobo that computer is also having a brain. Yes children, computer is also having a brain. Now let's move to the next page. The brain of the computer is known as central processing unit, and in short it is CPU. CPU is the brain of a computer, which helps it to remember everything, just like our own brain. The CPU helps a computer to process and perform various operations, store data and information. Now children, whatever the data and instruction we are giving to the computer, it is stored in the CPU. And whatever the work the computer has to do to give you the meaningful answer, it will also perform by the CPU. A CPU has two buttons, on off button and restart button. In the CPU, we are having two buttons. One is for switching on and switching off the CPU, and the other one is for restarting the CPU. Dobo. Dad, what is this tiny little thing with a long tail? Dad, this is called a mouse. Dobo, a real mouse? Dad, no, Dobo, it's not a real mouse. Come, I will tell you more about the computer mouse. Now, children, you must have seen a mouse. Yes, it is also known as a rat. But this is not the computer mouse. Next. Dad, Dobo, as you use your finger to point at things, similarly, a computer mouse also points on various objects on the computer screen. Therefore, it is also known as a pointing device. Now, Dad is telling Dobo about mouse. This is not the mouse we have found at our home. This is a simply different mouse. It is also known as a pointing device because it points on various objects on the computer screen. Dobo, Dad, but Mom told me not to point at others as it is a bad habit. Dad, yes, child, it's true. But in order to work with speed, a pointing device is essential. We can select anything on the screen very easily by clicking using the mouse. Now, in the computer screen, there are so many options. And with the help of mouse, we can select any option very easily. That's why we use mouse. A mouse is easy to use, increases speed and makes selection easier. It reduces the task of remembering as well as typing the commands. Now, mouse, I already told you, is very easy to use and it helps you to select different options given on the computer screen. As we can't remember all the commands, we can select the commands with the help of mouse. A mouse has three buttons: left mouse button, right mouse button, and scroll button. Let's see the picture of a mouse. See, in this activity, a picture of a mouse is given. See, first one is the left mouse button. In the middle, it is the scroll button. And the right side, we are having right mouse button. Now, left mouse button is used for single click, double click, and click and drag. Now, single click is used to select an option. Double click is used to open that particular file. And click and drag is used to draw on the screen. Now, scroll button, it will move page up and down. And right mouse button to open special menu. Whenever you click on the right mouse button, a special menu will open on the screen. Now, all of you please complete this activity according to the instructions given here. Color the left mouse button red. Color the right mouse button blue. Color the scroll button yellow. Color the body of mouse pink. And color the mouse pad gray. Now, children, for today, you will complete this activity. Okay? Now, in the next class, we will study the different uses of a computer. Okay?